to mimic this two paperclip.
A standard breaker suite for...
This, and this deck is only going to get better with the release of Black Orchestra and then the third piece, which is coming, I believe, in Martial Law. And when the game's begun, you've got defend, install.
This doesn't look like an easy deck to pilot at all. Whereas Alex's build looks pretty cool. We've got one magnet in here too, eh?
Yep.
All right, so Dean's starting off with a I've had worse, looking for some pieces. I will be right back, sorry.
So I'm not sure if he goes to check that move first turn. Maybe he's not that concerned about it. I think he just probably sets up here. I'm not sure why he's at 3 credits instead of 4. He's installed Vision. My apologies. That's right. Daily casts. Tossing a Deja Vu early on, that seems pretty dicey, but he does seem to have a lot of important cards in hand, ones that that Deja Vu would be working for. I think he just installs and takes a lot of money.
What's happened in the game thus far?
We've got a few more installs. Dean has tossed the Deja Vu, largely because he's got a lot of the pieces he wants already in hand. Uh-huh. So he's less scared of losing them to the destructive draw that Anner is known for.
That is his solo Deja Vu, though. He's,
that is the one Deja Vu, but I guess the pieces in his hand are just a little too important.
Fair enough.
I would have thought about tossing out the Grimoire,
because
the Grimoire isn't immune.
Yep.
That said, if Grimoire is then on Street Peddler with something really important, you can't hold on to it. It's a deck full of really tough choices. But when it fires on all cylinders, as you were on the bearing brunt of several times, once yesterday and several times the night before in testing, it wrecks.
Yeah. It is solid and consistent, apart from its draw engine, which can be dicey at times.
I mean, I tried it a few weeks ago, and my first run, my first inject, was 2 Yogs and a Mimic in the bin, which, before I could find any recursion, a Cronus Project destroyed the 2 Yogs. However, I still won that game.
Oh.
Because
wow.
Parasite is a card.
Yes, indeed.
Data Sucker's a card.
Oh, man. Hence this magnet in Alex's CTM build, I guess.
I guess he knows that a lot of his ice are just really easily parasitable. And a little spicy bit attack. It's interesting that he found room for that spicy kind of attack in a 12 influence build.
In a 12 influence build.
I can never really pass judgment on someone performing this well, this consistent. Like, he knows what he's doing.
So, thanks for bearing with me this stream. I'm going to switch in for our very own Travis Louis here. He's going to take over commentating duties.
Terrence Louis.
Oh, did I say Travis? Oh, I'm sorry. Terrence. Travis is our AV guy, and he's doing a bang up job of things. So we're switching in for Terrence here. He's going to take you through the rest of quarters and semis. We might have Andre swap in later, and we'll see who else we can get on here. Thanks very much. Come on in.
All right.
So we've seen a trash of Census Actors Union. We've seen a trash of Jackson Howard. He's just letting that Jackson go. He's not that concerned about getting things back. Maybe trying to pressure some of Dean's money, although he's got a lot of it. He's currently sitting on 14 credits.
But, like, Dean's going to eventually run out, right? Because when I played him yesterday, he had issues with just running out of steam halfway through the game, especially in a very grindy game like this. I do think that CTM has, like, this build of CTM has kind of a problem, and it doesn't seem that resilient to large medium digs, which I worry might happen.
Yeah, we've only got the one toolbook. We have 3 Archangels.
Yeah.
And on the other hand, no Spoon, so the Archangels continue to be a problem.
Yeah.
An Archangel is not an easy ice to parasite.
Right. Yeah, particularly because, like we said, this is a Yogg build, so eventually you're going to run out of Data Suckers. You're going to run out of... I mean, there are Ice Carvers, there's the Never Eyes, but again, it is a Yogg build, so all the heavy toll boots, Archangels, all that
right.
sort of stuff.
However, because it is Ice Light, because it's not running a CVS, there is no shutting off archives easily for data center counters.
Right, yeah. But you got the Astro.
And we got an Astro. Oh, and he's running my alt art. God bless him. not tournament legal, but you know what? Who cares? My heart is swelling with pride. Thank you, Alex.
So, he's already lost two pieces of ice, right? He lost the resistor.
Lost resistor and...
maybe just one.
And now, Quicksand.
Yes.
I like it as Temujin tech.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Yeah, I'm not sure... It's not... I wouldn't say it's great in an Anarch meta with
right.
lots of Ferris plates around.
He's going to toss that as well. And so the medium dig has begun.
Yeah.
With Alex only on two credits, it'll probably continue. But he's got a res Sansan.
Yeah.
And currently, Dean has no way of contesting that.
I think I see... I keep on leaning over to try to see what's in his hand.
I know. It never works, and I continue to do it, too.
He's got a Breaking News in hand, and a res Sansan, and an Astrotopian. So... The problem is, if Dean sees something big, hypothetically, he can get punished.
No! He's not happy about that.
Yeah, no.
And medium comes up
yeah.
for single access. And that's
yeah,
Jackson. Which is fine.
I can hear Dean. He's like, what, 20 feet away? I can still hear him going, yeah! It's in the background. Which is
yeah, a perfectly expectable card to see. But not ideal, as he is fairly low on credits. Spending one of those credits to try moving through his deck. But now what he's got is a number of fairly expensive to install breakers. His full suite costs 12 credits to install, and he's a long way off of that.
Yeah. He does have he dropped a Mimic.
He drops a Mimic. What does that mean? It means that he doesn't believe he'll need it.
Yeah, he doesn't have... Well, he's got two copies of every breaker, as he kept telling us this entire weekend.
Absolutely. So, but does he, like, if he knows his list up and down, you don't need a breaker for Data Raven. You just need money.
Because the only sentry is Data Raven.
And yet this is kind of the almost, the interesting thing, but unfortunate thing about knowing an opponent's deck really, really well, is that you can simply say, I have the answer for that, and
yeah.
I don't need more answers.
Right.
So the Sensis are gone, the Jacksons are gone. If he can find another Jackson, he can totally shut off the draw engine. Never mind. And we hear Dean's laugh because some of that is going to come back.
Yeah.
Namely, two Jacksons.
Two Jacksons.
And a Sensi.
Yeah.
That seems fair.
Yeah. Totally expected. The problem is I don't see Alex being... Well, controlling the message obviously protects the Sensis themselves, but I don't see him really being able to use the Sensis all that well. And also because it's an Ice Light build, do you think you can't really shut off Temujin, can you?
I think that you... It depends on what you draw, but I played a similar build to this one. It doesn't run a lot of remotes. It's able to run with fewer remotes, the way that it's built, to try and shut off that kind of Temujin
right.
Play. And when it does, when those remotes do come out, they're high powered. So are you going to let a Sensi stick around just so that you can get Temujin money off it? Are you going to let a Banker sit around? Maybe a Banker's, but not a Sensi. You can't.
Right.
That card has too much value. Your money isn't that important.
Right.
So we've got Yogg out, still a long ways off of being able to hit the Archangel, but at least is getting him through the pop-up for free.
Yeah, he can get through, again, he can get through the Magnet, Tobus when
yeah.
it comes up, maybe, but 3 of Archangel is really tough.
He's going to need he's going to need the Data Sucker to do any real work on it. Thank you very much. Those alt arts, if you're going to be at Worlds, I'll be bringing several with me. Please talk to me at Worlds, and I'll happily give you one. I printed a bunch extra. I just want to share the love. Also, those of you who are running tournaments and want the file to print off for yourself, feel free to sound off, and I'll try and get in contact with you, because I'd love for that to be seen everywhere. I put a lot of hard work into that, and a lot of love.
So I see Dean holding onto his parasite, top of his head. I think he's eyeing that quicksand, but.
I guess so, or no, it's Archangel.
Oh, it's Archangel.
Well, R&D is his win condition.
Right.
If he can get in there and stop the agendas from coming into Alex's hand,
yeah.
Then, well, Alex can't win. Alex can't score agendas if he doesn't see them.
Right.
So now he's just clicking to draw,
Yeah. Which
is not what the CTM wants to be doing. It wants to be drawing them for drawing like crazy with Sensi,
yep.
or at least Jackson drawing. But
right.
The Jacksons are one Jackson is gone. Two of them got shuffled in the deck. They'll show up, but we don't know if they'll do it in time.
Oh, he's gonna install the ice carver. Just get through, walk through all that for free.
Yeah.
Ice carver's coming out now, and he's gonna walk through it like four.
Well, yeah, I think he's got that on archives, and he's just gonna money up on it.
No, he's got the ice carver, so he can walk through the.
Well, no, but I'm saying the Temujin is on probably on archives.
No, he just installed a second ago.
Where's the ice carver?
It's in his hand.
Okay.
Right now.
No, but I'm saying the Temujin is on archives, I believe.
Did he run yet? No, he just installed a second ago. Oh, I guess so.
He's on three counters. He's taken off twice, which is why he's got the money to be installing things.
So I see. Right, there's another Temujin hand. Okay.
Yeah. And he's installed medium. It's got that one counter on it.
I mean, the problem with this is I see Alex purging now because he can get through the.
And I think that's okay for Dean.
Yeah.
Dean is fine with either of them.
Right.
For Alex to have to spend an entire turn purging, there is some. There's only three virus counters though. It's not a hugely valuable purge.
Right.
I call that a desperation purge. And I don't know if he's there yet. I think
he has to, because the reason why he has to purge is that next turn Dean can access five cards off RD.
Fair enough. But.
But I mean, at the beginning of Dean's turn, he's gonna have a third virus counter on the parasite.
Yeah, but Alex doesn't know that he has to.
Yeah.
All
but,
right. No, but.
Three, but it wouldn't matter.
Three parasite counters is enough for Yogg to walk through.
Regardless, he's installed another quicksand, which will keep Dean out for the meantime because Dean does not have access to a paperclip yet.
Right. And yep.
I think ideally a Data Raven would have been the best piece of ice there, but a quicksand will keep you out. And he's got some hard hitting. Oh, that is going to not be great for him, but not. Well, I think he's going to lose the Temujin.
Right.
So maybe you empty the Temujin,
yeah.
And then start clearing tags because. Or at least half empty it. Because. There's not a lot of punishment he can do
right.
At the moment. So he's trying to be okay regardless of whether closed accounts or Temujin is hit.
Trash, yeah.
Although both could be, if he's got a closed account, so he could just simply trash the Temujin, but he's not in a good space money-wise.
Right.
But
he still needs that paper.
Both players have fairly strong positions at the moment. With Dean having four tags and Alex having a little bit more money and decent ice.
He's drawn through. He's played, what, three hedge. Wait, five hedge funds, I think, at this point. Because he shuffled. No, I'm sorry, only three hedge funds. And then a whole bunch of sweeps.
Is he going to hard hit him again? I believe he might. I think he just did. I think we're going for an eighth tag so that he can. Maybe he's working on just permanent tagging.
No, but he's just trying to get money. Burn a lot of these money.
Yeah, just. So that wasn't another hard hitting news. That was my mistake. So now Dean is tagless.
Yep.
Yeah. So hard hitting news, not doing a lot besides a little bit of tempo.
Right. Although tempo is of course important.
Yeah.
We just let the Archangel go. Oh, there's gonna be a.
I think he gave him the Archangel, yeah. Hilariously. Which we've all done a few times. That seemed like the early Archangel death.
No, it was at. It was at six? Five. It just reached six.
Okay, I thought it was going to five.
Dean drew first, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4 is running on 10 units. The last drop is a hag, I think.
Drops the tag, and empties out Temujin.
Yeah. And now he's got the 8 in case there's another hard hitting. Of course, I'm not quite sure. What do you think that remote is?
Is he gonna toss the Ice Carver? What has he got that's valuable right now? The daily cast probably has least value. Yeah.
But he still needs money, but he has what?
Two Temujin
in hand.
Yeah. So I think he's okay. If he can get a paperclip, Temujin and R&D is value.
Yeah. Just getting in there for free, getting all that money, yogging through that.
So I think Dean is basically trying to figure out whether he clicks to draw. Mm-hmm. Because he's out of draw engine cards.
Yep. He does.
I think he has to, because he doesn't. He needs a paperclip. He needs a paperclip to move on.
Or he needs another parasite. There's another device there. I wonder what it is. You didn't see it when it went down, did you?
I did not.
All right. So both the quick turns are out. It could be.
He was perusing the archives.
Right.
So it could be that he was looking at how many parasites are left.
Right.
He's got a parasite on the Street Peddler, which could be very, very good if he can get the data sucker on the board.
And now that thing is advanced. It must be a GFI, I think.
It very well could be a GFI or a. So Alex is definitely in a good position here, and Dean just needs a breaker.
Yep. Well, he could. There was a parasite on that peddler, so he could get through. He
could get through the quicksand, but I would imagine that the ice on R&D is still going to be a pain for Dean. Otherwise, why would he install it?
Could be another Archangel. Could be a Tolbooth.
So Dean's definitely under the gun here.
Right.
Because if Alex has another 2-point agenda, he just wins.
Right. Why do you think Dean installed that?
He wanted to get rid of the. It is an Archangel.
Yeah.
So he's going to get 2 accesses at R&D.
Yeah.
And hopefully clear out any agendas that might be coming into hand. So he sees 1, he sees 2, yeah. Just sees some ice.
I'm very surprised that Dean installed that parasite before running.
It was the only winning play. It was the only.
No, but he could have run and then wait until before access and then before encounter. Sorry, and then installing it then.
You're right. You're right.
Because if it was, let's say, maybe he wanted to save that click.
So Alex has to protect R&D. Oh, this
unless
is interesting.
He has the Beal in hand.
No, if he has the Beal, he just wins.
Right.
So that's not part of this.
Right, because he had the tag from the killing the quicksand.
Oh, I guess he wanted to capitalize on the turn. Interesting that he wouldn't clear that.
So it would be fine if Dean stole the DFI right now because Alex doesn't have any high value or low value agenda that he could trade away.
Caesar Jackson that he trashes.
Yep.
They can go in one more time.
Yeah. I'm a little surprised Dean hasn't installed the data sucker.
Well, he doesn't have any money.
Oh, right, that's true.
And there's a breaking news.
There's breaking news, which is totally fine for Dean DeSteele.
Yeah.
Totally fine for Dean DeSteele. UI does nothing for that. What could Dean cause? Yeah, he's not installing that Liberty anytime soon. Oh, what happened?
Oh, it was a GFI.
Oh, right, yeah. In the remote itself, okay.
And that's game.
That's game.
So Dean, this knocked Dean out of contention, and Alex continues on to loser semis.